The new mine's boss wants the sector to contribute more meaningfully to the economy. To do this, there is need to set up value addition facilities locally.
We need to have our own refineries, and I keep repeating this.
Zimbabwe's diamonds are exported raw and sustain thousands of cutting and polishing jobs abroad. Similarly, platinum, which has reached a record 400,000 ounces output this year, is being processed elsewhere. Players in the sector have stonewalled a push to set up a refinery here.
Two of the three companies operating in Zimbabwe today belong to the same parent company in South Africa. The company has already invested money in a base metal refinery, in a smelter, a base metal refinery, and a precious metal refinery. It does not have the interest of setting up another base metal refinery and another precious metal refinery in Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe has the second largest deposit of platinum and says that justifies investment in a refinery whose cost could run into billions. Questions remain about where the capital to fund such a project would come from. Existing indigenization laws have discouraged significant inflows in the mining sector. However, government is adamant mineral processing should happen in country. The mining sector has also been blighted by allegations of corruption, particularly in the diamond sector. Currently, no dividends have been remitted to the National Treasury amidst accusations of looting of the gemstones. The new minister has vowed to clean up operations.
I want to know, could the excavator that picked up the earth, 10 tons of it in the excavator, and put it in the density medium separator, which separates the diamonds from the chaff. I want to know that every diamond that was picked up is actually at the table accounted for. That's what I want to know.
Zimbabwe's diamonds are expected to increase global output by between 25% and 30%. The EU recently lifted sanctions on the government-owned Zimbabwe Mining Development Corporation, which is expected to boost revenue and that in turn increase contribution to the national fiscus.
And that could help in solving some of the funding headaches that this government faces as it battles to turn around this economy. Farai Mwakutuya, CCTV, Harare, Zimbabwe.